first throw, and not a single vehicle was damaged when he breathed his last 2 or 3 years ago. Courier figures like Serai and Kuntush died in jail, and yet the government did not take to the streets. Many may argue that it is the fear of the state that kept the people inside, but believe me, it is not the full truth. The full truth is Pakistan successfully came to infiltrate all important aspects of our civil society. Thanks to the resonant so-called mainstream politics in the Delhi, there is overwhelming evidence to show that many had honed the art of running with the hare and hunting with the hound to a near science that left both the common men and the security men bewildered, frightened and confused. Visiting homes of killed terrorists and expressing sympathy in public became the new normal. While elimination of new recruits to terrorism was allowed and tacitly encouraged, those who facilitated the recruitment, arranged finances, were never investigated. And it was forbidden to even go near Jamaat-e-Islami that provided the religious and ideological justification to the perfidies of the terrorists and the Bharat. This was despite being an open secret that the Jamaat network was not only able to sabotage government efforts to normalize the situation, but also had a terror finance network that played a big role in mobilizing street protests. It was blasphemous to even think of countering this, who vilified everything about the Indian state and its armed forces as part of a deliberate and systematic creation and propagation of false narratives based on half-truths, out-of-context presentation of facts, malicious and selective muting, and amplification and outright falsehoods. SP-ranking officers were thrown behind bars and put alongside terrorists in jails for crimes they never committed. Death by accident. By accident, the drowning of Nilofer and Asiya in Shopian in 2014 was allowed to be hijacked by the narrative terrorism who held the very to ransom with several weeks long hartal, arson and rioting. A very deep and detailed investigation by CBI, backed by forensics of the All India Institute of Medical Sciences, proved it beyond any shadow of doubt that it was outright false. The things have come to such a pass that the so-called mainstream party had started cultivating leaders of terrorist networks through intermediaries and sometimes directly to further their electoral prospects. It is the unflinching stance and strategy of the Government of India and the armed forces and the police and the law enforcement, backed by a latent population since last several years, that this duality and dubious duplicity will be put to an end or an attempt made towards it, which has put the national security adversary in the back foot. It is a call at the highest level of policy making that political and economic opportunities would no longer be the prerogative of a privileged few and would become available to one and all is one major reason why I believe the streets are getting calm. For a long time, when you administer a cocktail of propaganda, fear and intimidation and fill it to the population, it is bound to have some time before the effect can be actually made to wear out. This is a subtle way by which the common man in Kashmir is conveying, by refraining from taking to the streets, that while before this fog of fear, intimidation and propaganda by Pakistan and its proxies have thinned, it is possible to walk the remaining distance and walk into the bright sunshine for good. I often, in my discussion with my colleagues, leave it to the field-level experts with vast knowledge, skill, and experience to discuss and deliberate upon the nuts and bolts of the tactics and strategies to counter the challenges arising out of hybrid terrorists, out of deployment of drones by the adversary, infiltration and smuggling of terrorist hardware through new tunnels, narcotics as the new terror currency, radicalization and narrative war over the social media. The enemy fervently hopes, wishfully, that through targeted killings of soft and vulnerable sections of our citizenry, such as minorities, pilgrims, non-local laborers, non-JNK employees from other parts of Jammu and Kashmir and outside India, of duty policemen and security personnel on leave. They would debunk and discredit the current approach and give grist to the proponents of the management theory to restore the old ways of doing things. Pakistan and its proxies would consider it a godsend opportunity to preserve and protect their last vestiges of influence in Kashmir if we had to go back and do things in our old ways.